Hello there, a very good morning. You're watching Proactive and London. A warm welcome back. Today we are discussing Greencoat UK Wind, and we've got Steve and Lilley with us today because you've agreed to acquire a net 12.5% stake in the Hornsea 1 offshore wind farm for around £400 million. So we're going to go through the details of that deal. A very good morning to you, Stephen. So tell us more.
Good morning, Katie. Yes, so delighted, actually. We've been looking at it for a while, and completed on Friday night for announcement this morning. So Hornsea 1 is the biggest wind farm in the world, I think, certainly biggest in the UK, and it's about 1.2 gigawatts of capacity, and we're buying 12.5% of that from Global Infrastructure Partners. So we'll sit there with 50% partner Ørsted, which we've got on a number of different projects. And so sort of delighted to do that. I think with sort of big projects, those are the sort of size of stakes that people generally buy. And so for us, it's a very big investment, about just over £1.1 billion worth of gross asset value. So it comes with approximately £700 million of debt on that, which we add to our corporate debt, and £400 million of equity. So big investment for us, but delighted.
All right. And this is expected to be completed in the third quarter, I understand, of this year. And it will be funded from your cash flow and the company's revolving credit facility then.
Yeah, predominantly. It's hard to work out to some extent, given the volatility in power prices, how much cash we will generate. But we are cash generative at the moment. And we suspect, actually, by the time we get to third quarter, that we will have generated quite a lot of that £400 million we already have done so far in the year, quite a bit of that. So we'd expect to do that.
And how does this complement what is already in your portfolio?
Yeah, so we've got, as I've announced probably quite a while ago, we've got a number of subsidy-free projects, and that sort of match, I guess, of alongside the sort of core of the rock projects that we have, with which have the ROC certificate and also the merchant that goes alongside that. So buying the fixed sort of bit, the CFD that we have with Hornsea, but also the subsidy-free projects that we have with projects like South Kyle, which will come in about a year's time, or maybe 9 months' time, you know, a good match of the sort of cash flows to produce the very stable income stream from the ROC or the CFD, matched by this merchant, which obviously have great value to us at the moment. On Hornsea, out of the 174 7-megawatt turbines, we produce at the moment £175 a megawatt hour from the CFD, we'll match that, I guess, against as I said, the subsidy free projects that come in over the next little while.
Mm-hmm. And in your commentary, it says you see an attractive pipeline of projects going forward, both onshore and offshore. Can you maybe just give us an idea as to what you're kind of eyeing up?
Yeah, well, I think at any time we look at a lot of new projects. We see fair bit of recycling still, so I think across all of the rock projects that we see, but also this mix then, I guess, of CFD projects, quite a lot of them are offshore, quite a lot of them will be big, and a few of them will have project finance sitting alongside them, and then the subsidy-free projects that we've committed to, but also we sort of see continue sort of building out. So I think it's across all of that. We're still 6% of the UK wind market, with a market that's going to grow obviously substantially over the next 20 or 30 years. So we look at each project as it comes. We try and buy well when we can. Well, if we buy well all the time, but buy projects when we can, value creative to the business, and just gradually we've grown. So with Hornsea 1 coming in, and also 20 Shilling, which is completing either this week or next, we'll be up to somewhere in the region of £5.5 billion of assets, and something like 3.9 of net asset value, and not a million miles off the FTSE 100. We're somewhere in the region of 108, I think, as we speak, maybe slightly lower than that, but exciting. We haven't particularly intended to grow for any particular target. We just want to make good investments, and I think we sort of see the market as such that we can continue to do that, and we're of a scale that we can you know, we can make meaningful investments in big projects like Hornsea 1.
Mm-hmm. And at the end of March, you increased your net asset value quite substantially.
Yeah, I mean, so all themes that I think so people would understand. So cash generation through the first, well, the end of last year and beginning this year in Q1. Alongside that, I think, you know, we do benefit from inflation in the sense that revenue and costs are inflation linked. Therefore, as we sort of see higher inflation, it helps to be able to, we can increase the dividend by the RPI inflation, which we have done nine times, I think it is, certainly every year anyway. Those numbers then go into the net asset value calculation as well. So the inflation is probably worth about 6 pence for the component for 2022. Mm-hmm. And then we benefit from the increase in future power pricing, albeit the volatility is something we try and cater for and assess that on a hopefully relatively conservative basis, mm-hmm. a sensible basis, I think, given the volatility that you see in the markets that everyone understands.
Stephen, always a pleasure. Thank you very much indeed for taking us through your news this morning from Greencoat UK Wind here on Proactive.
Thank you.